Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Aaron Landry is going to go all the way to the house. Landry gets the outside again.
Lovely on the carry. Not-
breaks through and he's into the end zone. He is dropped in the backfield by Kiernan Freeman. First handoff. Nice little bit of razzle dazzle there as the handoff went to Worley, then it went to Landry, and Landry's off to the races. Touchdown! No Wanter just plowed through three or four tacklers. Frontier Red Hawk football. Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Opening night from South Deerfield as the Drury Blue Devils out of North Adams come to Deerfield to take on the Frontier Red Hawks. Hi again, everyone. This is Chris Collins, Kevin Murphy, and the crew alongside for what should be a very interesting opening night matchup, independent matchup, as the Red Hawks, who come in with a loaded backfield, to take on the Drury Blue Devils, who last year did not start out strong but finished the season very strongly, and I'm told have a pretty good backfield of their own. This should be a very, very interesting game. And we're going to pause for the national anthem and get this one started. With that, we are set to get underway here from South Deerfield. A beautiful night for football. A little humid, but it is early September, and these early games in September sometimes are a bit warm, and certainly this is definitely the case tonight. Red Hawks will be led in the backfield by Miles Freeman, the quarterback, Aaron Landry, Steph Worthley, and Seth Gawanter are also in the backfield, and that is a powerful running team. Last year, Frontier opened the season at Amherst. That was a wild game. Red Hawks won it in the last minute.
Opening kickoff.
And the Hawks will get the ball to start this one. And like I said, the Drury Blue Devils last year started the season, I think, with three or four losses. They lost badly to Greenfield. I actually saw that game. And they didn't look good, but they won their last eight of the season, so definitely a program on the upswing.
For the Blue Devils, back for the Red Hawks.
Landry and Worthley are in deep for
Stephen Worthley,
the Red Hawks.
Aaron Landry.
There's always a little bit of rust to bang off the old shoulder pads to start off the first game. We'll see how much rust there is on both sides of the ball. Red Hawks in their brand new red home uniforms with the stripes on the shoulders, looking very good. Hayden Bird to kick it off for Drury. It's a short kick taken at about the 15-yard line, and it'll get it up past the 30, and he's still on his feet. That is Matt Hildreth. Deep into Drury territory, and that is just what the doctor ordered to start things off for the Red Hawks. That's about a, I would say, about a 50-yard return by Hildreth. And that'll bring up first and 10 inside, deep inside Drury territory at the 37. Try to make it the 32. So I'm told this is going to be a strong backfield attack, but there could be a couple of trick plays mixed in. Freeman under center. And the give goes on the inside to Wordley. He gets up to about the 26-yard line or so.
Tackle number 61.
So that's going to be a gain of about 6. Bring up second and 4.
7, second and 3 for the Hawks.
Gowaner in the backfield. And again, the handoff up the middle, Wordley again. And he picks up a first down.
Carry good for a Red Hawk first down.
We'll see where they spot it.
First and 10 Frontier.
That ball is at about the 15-yard line.
15-yard line.
So that was a gain of about 11. Now a counter play again to number 29, Wordley, up the middle. And he's brought down inside the 10, it looks like. So all Stephen Wordley in this series.
Carbosiero on the stop.
It's going to get him down to about the 10-yard line, so that's a gain of 5.
Gain of 6, second and 4.
He'll make that 6, second and 4 from the 9. And the inside give.
Aaron Landry on a carry.
Went to Landry.
For a first down for the Hawks.
And that's going to be a first and goal from about the 5.
4-yard line.
He just got thrown to the ground. Pretty significant by a linebacker.
And the inside give. Gets it down to about the 1. That's Landry again.
On the carry.
So, really surgical ground game right
Jack
now. That gets down to the 1. It's a gain of
second
4.
Goal.
Second and goal from the 1 of Drury, as they have had no answer for the running attack of Frontier. Inside give the Gowanter is good for a touchdown. So that's about as good as it gets when you talk about an opening drive for Frontier. As just like that, they lead it 6-0 on a Gowanter 1-yard run. They'll go for the 2-point conversion.
Hawks will attempt the 2-point conversion.
The Freeman's pass.
Freeman's pass
is complete.
Complete to number 29, Stephen Wordley.
So the pass from Freeman to Wordley is complete. And we'll go back up the field. Frontier leading 8-0. This is high school football on Frontier Community Access Television. Well, that took all of a minute and 49 seconds and 6 plays before Frontier finds the end zone for the first time this season. And they lead 8-0. Move the ball pretty much at will. Mostly Wordley and then Landry, and then they finish it off with the big man, Gowanter, the captain, up the middle.
Corbin Blake to kick off for the Red Hawks.
Frontier will kick it off. We'll get the first look at the defense of the Red Hawks.
Kalen Harrison back
goes
to
down to
the
about the 15-yard line. And he is brought down, that is Harrison, who's brought down at about the 28-yard line. It's good for about a 13-yard
run. Harrison's on a stop for the Red Hawks. First and 10, Blue Devils.
So Drury will get their first crack on offense.
33-yard line.
33-yard line is where they're going to pick it up. And we'll see what this offense, led by quarterback Obilio Rodriguez, has to offer. They set up in an I formation. Near side wide out is Yeaton. Inside handoff goes to Harrison.
Harrison on the carry.
Harrison crosses the 35 to about the 37-yard line. It's a pickup of about 4.
For Frontier, gain of about 5.
Second and 5
and
6
for the Blue Devils.
On the 37-yard line.
Yeah.
8:17 to go in the first quarter. 8-0 Frontier with the lead. Second, and we'll call it a long five for Drury. And again, the inside give goes to Harrison.
Harrison on a carry.
He's close to first down yardage. See where they spot it.
Pat McGranahan on a stop for the Redhawks. Carry good for a Blue Devil first down.
He is good for a first down.
First and 10, Drury from the Drury 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7. So Drury moving the ball with Thalen Harrison getting the first two gives. As I recall, Drury threw the ball a little bit last year against Greenfield with very little success. But they stick to mostly a ground game, as most Berkshire teams do. The receiver goes in motion. That's Bird. And it's going to be a counter run to the left side. And that's Bay, and he is brought down. Jamal Beta, met by Miles Freeman. Although he does get into Frontier territory to about the 48. And at the 49.
Gain of 6, 2nd and 4 for the Blue Devils.
So both these teams like to run the ball. And so far, both have had pretty good success. Although I would argue Frontier's success in that first series was pretty dominant. Pitch again goes to Beta, and Beta gets hit in the backfield and is dropped for a loss. And is there a fumble on the play? There's a
Aaron Landry on a stop for
nope.
The Hawks.
Just a
loss
on the
of
ground.
A couple yards.
He ended up losing actually 2 yards on that one. And that'll bring up third and six from the 49 of Drury. With 6:25 to go in quarter number one. We got a full house backfield, and quarterback Rodriguez in the shotgun. Inside give to the fullback. He gets it back
Harrison
to about
a
50. That's
Red
Harrison
Hawks.
Again. Good swarming tackling by the Red Hawks. Actually got back to the original line of scrimmage. They picked up the 2 he lost. That's going to bring up 4th and 4 from the 49
fourth
of
five
Frontier.
From midfield.
And make it the 50. We'll see if they punt it here. I would think it's early in the game, probably, but chance if they get a good kick to hem the Redhawks back deep in their own end. Worthy is back, the lone man back for the Redhawks. And they are going to punt it, looks like, but wouldn't be above a fake here, potentially. Low snap, and trouble handling it. Harrison does get the kickoff, barely. That's a pretty good kick. Goes all the way down inside the 5. Boy, that's a break. Harrison had a tough time handling the snap and ended up getting a great kickoff, good spiral, and they're going to be inside Frontier is their own 5-yard line at about, I would say, the 3. So a long field for the Redhawks to work with here. Again, Frontier leads 8-0 on the Gawanter 1-yard run and the Wordley pass from Freeman for the extra point for 2-point conversion. This can get dangerous here. We'll see what they do for an offensive set. It's inside handoff as they push it up the middle, trying to get out of the briar patch, as they would say. They cross the 5 up to about, I would say, the 7 or 8 yard line. Wordley again. He's gotten most of the touches in this game.
Gain of 5, 2nd and 5.
He got 5 on that one. So that'll be 2nd and 5 from the 8 of Frontier. Freeman under center. Oh, counter run the other way. And oh, look at this. Wordley got a hold. He's gone. They are not going to catch Steven. Aaron Landry is going to go all the way to the house. That is a 92-yard touchdown run for Aaron Landry. Wow. 92 yards. too. Yeah.
92-yard touchdown run, 23.
Well, he got a great block on the outside, and all you got to give is Landry that much daylight, and he is gone. And just like that, it is 14-0. Well, what looked like it was going to be a tough series because they were so deep at their own end turns out to be a 92-yard touchdown run for Aaron Landry. Two-point conversion setup. Going to go to Gawanter up the gut. Plows ahead. Is he going to get in? Yes!
Gawanter
bowls his way through for the two-point conversion. And just like that, the Red Hawks are rolling. 4:13 to go in the first quarter. On the scoreboard, it's the Frontier Redhawks 16, the Drury Blue Devils nothing. Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Well, we knew that the Frontier Redhawks were going to have a good running game this year. I don't think we knew quite how good. Okay, this is only the second series of week one, but if you're a Redhawk fan, you got to like what you're seeing. 16-0. Two touchdown runs, a short one by Gawanter for one, and a 92-yard run for Landry up the left sideline. And Frontier will kick it off, leading 16-0. And the route is on. A short kick at about the 20, taken by Harrison, cuts back up the other way. And is tripped up at around
Harrison
the
on return.
30, I'm gonna say the 33-yard line. And so that's good for a 13-yard return. And that's where Drury will start their second series. Again, Blue Devils look like a pretty decent team. They've got some fundamentals. They haven't made many mistakes
Devils
early
ball,
on.
First and 10.
Just have no answer right now for the Frontier Drury running
38-yard line.
Ball we spotted actually at the 38. And that's where the Blue Devils will start their second series. Now the shotgun, inside handoff goes to Harrison. He's hit in the backfield, and he's going to lose about, I would say, 2 yards on that one.
Stop for the Red Hawks.
Again, good penetration by the Frontier line.
Loss of a couple yards. Second and 12.
Second and 12 from the 36 of Drury. 3:47 to go in period number one. Opening night in South Deerfield. And the Frontier Red Hawks, from what I'm told, are focused on a team from the Berkshires, but it's not necessarily Drury, although they are this week. They want Hoosick in the playoffs again. They want that rematch. Play action out of the shotgun. The pass is batted down.
Abelio Rodriguez pass
and that
incomplete.
Was Rodriguez with the pass, and
third
that was
and
incomplete.
For the Blue Devils.
That'll bring up third and 12 from the 36 of Drury. Don Gordon expecting big things from his line on both sides of the ball this year. They have had dominant front four for the last few years, and no reason to think it's going to be any different this year. Third and 12. Pass completes, and the Drury defender gets away. That is Bird, and Bird is still running down the sidelines, and he gets by everybody in for the touchdown. Well,
good for a Blue Devil touchdown, 62-yard touchdown pass.
Just like that, it's 16-6.
Tanner Bird.
That's good for 64 yards.
Sorry, Hayden. Yeah, Tanner's the hockey player.
Well. That was a nice individual effort by Bird there as he caught the pass at about midfield and was able to juke a couple of defenders, got the outside, and just took off down the right sideline.
62-yard touchdown pass from Abelio Rodriguez to number 11, Hayden Bird. That was an attempt at two-point conversion.
Drury's going to go for two here. They set up in the I formation. Double wideouts on the near side. Snap goes to Rodriguez, and it looked like it was fumbled. And the two-point conversion
no good.
Fails.
Fumbled. 305.
So
they
come back up the field.
Red Hawks,
305 to go in the first. It's Frontier 16, Drury 6. This is high school football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins back here at Frontier Regional School as the Drury Blue Devils are on the board with a 64-yard touchdown pass from Rodriguez to Hayden Bird. Back deep, Worthy and Landry for Frontier. We'll see if that scoring drive boosts up the Drury Blue Devils. Bird, who just scored the touchdown, ready to kick it off for the Blue Devils. Nice night for football here in South County. And Bird pops the ball in the air, and it's been taken about the 15-yard line by Landry. Landry up the middle, tries to find a seam, can't, and is brought down at about the 38-yard line. That'll be good for
61. Nick Arnold on a
about
stop
a 22-yard
for the Blue
return.
Red Hawks ball first and 10.
First and 10 Frontier.
The Frontier 37
their
yard
own
line.
37. Double tight end offense. And a given motion to Landry. Landry gets the outside again, and he's knocked out of bounds.
Knocked out of bounds by
it was actually Worthy. Knocked out of bounds at about the 45-yard line of Drury, so he is in
very good
to Drury territory about the 45.
For a Red Hawk first down. First down Frontier from the Blue Devil 45-yard line.
That sweep is a very effective play. That was good for 18 there by Worthy. And the Hawks are in business again inside Drury territory. An inside give to Landry and a counter. Landry has first down yardage inside the 35 to about the 33. So that inside counter is very effective as well. It's good for a first, so moving the chains. At will almost, it seems. And that was good for 12. So these Frontier backs racking up the yardage here in the first quarter. Inside give that time goes to Gawanter, and he has
Gawanter
a first down.
On a carry. Galen Harrison on a stop.
And they are just steamrolling downfield. That's three consecutive first downs on runs. That is not too shabby if you're a Frontier Redhawk fan. They've picked up
10 from the Blue Devil.
40 yards on three carries.
23-yard line.
That's pretty amazing. Inside handoff again, goes to Worthy, follows his blockers. He may have another first down.
Carry.
He might not have gotten the first down yet, but he's pretty close. Maybe have to measure this.
Timeout called by the Red Hawks.
Frontier calls a timeout. We'll see where they set the change. You're watching, listening to Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. This is one of a number of games we're going to be doing this year as we chronicle the Red Hawks. I think we might even be going on the road a little bit this year, which would be nice. And I'll be doing some of the commentary, and our friends from Bear Country will also be helping out as they're beginning their season, I believe, next week. This Frontier team is loaded in the backfield, and they're proving it. Defensively, Jerry's still out, but that was, again, a great individual effort by Bird to get Drury on the board the last series. That last run by Worthy was good for 7 yards. Brings up second and three from the 16 of Drury with 1:50 to go in quarter number one. Game one of a number of independent matchups around Franklin County this evening as we open the season. Inside give goes to Gawanter. Gawanter breaks through and he's into the end zone. Bounced off one tackler and into the end zone. No stopping that guy when he decides to go to the house. He takes it in. and that makes it 22-6. That's good for a 16-yard touchdown run.
Frontier
sets up the two-point conversion. And rolling out is Freeman. Stays on his feet, but is brought down short.
Freeman on a carry conversion is no good.
Of the two-point conversion. Come back
air,
up field. 1:43 to go in the first quarter.
22.
The scoreboard, it's Frontier 22. Drury 6. This is high school football on Frontier Community Access Television. So 1:43 to go in quarter number one, and Frontier Redhawks have scored on three consecutive offensive series. Three running plays. 1 yard run for Gawanter, a 92-yard run for Landry. 92 yards. And a 16-yard run for Gawanter to make it 22-6.
Corbin's like to kick off.
Like to kick it off for the Frontier Redhawks. Deep kick over the head of the deep man, but he picks it up back at about his own 10.
That's it,
seven.
On the return.
And he is brought down back deep in his own end.
On the stop for the Red Hawks.
See where they spy. Looks like it's around the 15.
Blue Devils first and 10.
So Drury will start their third series deep in their own end. See where they spot it.
First and 10 Devils from their own 15-yard line.
They start at the 15. A long field for Rodriguez and the Blue Devils. One thing we have not seen a lot of are mistakes. Usually in the first week, it's, like I said, banging the rust off the shoulder pads.
Timeout
but both teams
Blue Devils
in mid-season form, at least right now. Drury calls time. This may be a 22nd timeout. And they did not like what they saw from the Frontier defense. It's always good to see so many familiar faces. Marty Sanderson, the athletic director here. I'm told, and this is a bit of a scoop, is going to coach girls basketball this year. So Marty Sanderson getting back in the coach's box, coaching the Frontier Redhawk girls this year. And we'll be definitely be doing some Frontier basketball games this year, some girls games. That was a lot of fun last year. We had a great time covering the Hawks and, of course, the improbable playoff run and the great story for the boys. And the girls really had a fun year. It was a fun team to watch, and it'll be fun to see what they have this winter. First and 10, Drury at their own 15, 1:35 to go in quarter number one. Red Hawks lead 22-6. Shotgun formation again. Rodriguez. Inside give.
Jalen Harrison on the carry.
Harrison, he gets a hole, breaks back up the middle, and has first down yardage, and that was just what the doctor ordered for the Drury Blue Devils, as they get a big first down run.
Field is on a stop for the Red Hawks.
Gets them out of their own end and up to about the 31-yard line. That's good for 16 yards. First and 10 from the 31. Clock is in motion. A lot of scoring in this first quarter. Rodriguez. And an inside handoff.
Beta on the carry.
And Beta is stopped. Got a couple of yards before he is brought down.
51. Pat McGranahan on a stop for.
Let's see how many. He's got about maybe. Yeah, he got about 2 yards. Give him 2 second and eight from the 33.
Second down, second and eight for the Blue Devils.
Less than a minute to go in quarter number one. Rodriguez out of the shotgun again. One man in motion. Inside give goes to Beta up the middle, and he gets pulled down and stopped short of the first down. Up and around the 38-yard line, so he got about five.
Devil's ball.
And that'll bring it third and three, and that's going to be the last play of the first quarter. We have played one quarter from South Deerfield. On the scoreboard, it's the Frontier Redhawks 22.
First quarter here at the Frontier.
And the Brewery Blue Devils 6. We'll change ends and come back with second quarter action. You're watching Frontier Redhawk football on Frontier Community Access Television.
Concession stand is open.
So an interesting first quarter scoring-wise for the Frontier Redhawks.
Frontier football parents,
they got it going on their first series. Brett Gawantra with a one-yard run set up by a number of long runs by Stephen Worthley and Aaron Landry. And then Landry scored on the next series in a 92-yard touchdown run. And then Bird came back and caught a long pass, 64 yards, and Drury was able to get on the board. And then Gawantra, the 16-yard run in the last series, and that's how it ended up. 22-6, Frontier at the end of one quarter. And Drury will start the second quarter with the ball. The third and three situation from their own 38-yard line. Play 11-minute quarter is independent in high school football. It's an independent game. Shotgun formation again, empty backfield. Wide outs on either side for Rodriguez. The inside give goes to Bega, and he gets another yard or so, maybe.
Jamal Beta on the carry.
Up to about the 40, so he'll probably get two. This is going to be close to first down yards, but I don't think he's got it.
Gain of about a yard, it'll be.
Be fourth and one, I believe. Just about fourth and one from the 40.
Time out for a measurement.
They're going to measure, but I don't think it's going to be that close. We'll see. I'm pretty sure that they're going to have to punt this ball. Unless they got the first down, I don't think they got it.
Fourth and inches.
Yep, fourth and just inside of a yard. So, I don't know, maybe you go for it here, down 22-6. Maybe you think about just a quick fullback dive play. We'll see what the Drury coaching staff decides to do here. Could see a quarterback keeper. Just hit the ball and tap the center on the back and just dive through. Although he cut tough through that in the shotgun, which is now Rodriguez goes up. And he's exactly introduced that, but I don't think he got it. I don't know if he got it. That second effort might have gotten him through. We'll see where they spot it.
First down, Blue
Devils. Yep, he did get it. So the gamble paid off for Rodriguez. Abelio gets a fresh set of downs.
First and 10, Drury from the Drury 41-yard line.
So he got about a yard on that one, so just enough to move those chains. Looked like the Frontier line might have had him stopped there, but I think that second effort, that second push, sometimes is all it takes to get across that line. So a fresh set of downs for the Blue Devils. Shotgun again, Rodriguez. Inside hand to Beta.
Beta
is stopped again at about the original line of scrimmage. We'll see where they spot it. Looks like their Frontier sniffing out that counterplay. He might have got one. We'll see.
No gain, second and 10.
No gain. Second and 10 from the 41-yard line of Drury. We've added a new wrinkle to our coverage here at that. A drone. We're going to see some drone footage tonight, courtesy of Kevin Murphy, who loves that drone. Rodriguez gets the snap, inside hand to Beta, and again he's met at the line of scrimmage. Once again, Frontier end staying at home, and I don't think he got anything that time either. Frontier line coming up big.
Seth Gawantra.
Yep, Gawantra again. Stunting linebacker.
On a stop for the Hawks.
And he gets no gain again. So this is third and 10. You don't often see this. Someone gets stopped two downs in a row like that in the same play. Might want to mix it up a little bit. Triple receivers to the near side for Rodriguez. Blitz coming. Rodriguez rolls back and is going to get sacked. He is dropped in the backfield by Kiernan Freeman. Nicely done by Freeman. And this time they're going to have no choice but to punt as they're way back at the 30. That's a loss of 11.
Fourth and 22.
Fourth and 21 from the 30 of Drury. So great job by Kiernan Freeman, the sophomore tight end.
Drive back to punt for
came in and
Drury.
Just dropped the hammer on the quarterback.
To receive for
Harrison to kick it away for Drury. Now a whistle, stoppage of play. And a timeout, for Drury. We'll take a quick break, 7:28 to go in the first half. Frontier 22, Drury 6. This is Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. So fourth and 21 for the Drury Blue Devils. They are going to kick it away, courtesy of that sack by Kiernan Freeman. Harrison back deep to boot it. And Landry will go back deep for the Red Hawks at about his own 40-yard line. Harrison, a high end-over-end kick. Landry takes it at the 41. Avoids one tackler, avoids two. Flag on the play.
Flag on the play.
And I think you're going to see a block in the back here.
Landry on the return. Taylor Fortini on a stop for the Devils.
We'll see what this call is. It's going to be on Frontier. So they're going to knock him back.
Knocking it back on the Red Hawks. 10-yard penalty. It'll be first and 10 for Frontier.
Block in the back. It's going to be first and 10.
And Frontier 28-yard line.
The 28-yard line for Frontier. Inside reverse handoff. Nice little bit of razzle dazzle there as the handoff went to Worley, then it went to Landry, and Landry's off to the races, and he's inside. Oh, I think we're going to get a face mask here. Flag down. Again, that was a little bit of an inside razzle dazzle play. Worley hands it off inside to Landry. He's raked down by his face mask. It's going to be a first down. But how deep it goes into Drury territory will depend. That's what it was a horse collar.
15-yard penalty, first down for Frontier.
And that's going to spot the ball at about the 10-yard line.
First and 10 from the 11-yard line. Stephen Worthley on a carry. Fumble on a play.
Oh, fumble recovered as Worthley got stripped of the ball and it got brought back the other way. Oh my goodness. And they're not going to catch the guy.
Baylen Harrison.
Harrison runs it back. 85-yard fumble recovery. Wow. How about that? They had the ball at the 11. Worthley bounced to the outside, got stripped, and Harrison brought it back for 85 yards for a fumble recovery to make it 22-12.
Hey, we got.
Devils will attempt a two-point conversion.
I didn't see who stripped the ball on Worthy, but someone got a hand on it. And and the two-point conversion run is no good.
No good.
So we'll head back upfield as the Drury defense gets one for the Blue Devils. It's 22-12 with 6:41 to go in the half. High school football on Frontier Community Access Television. So quite a turn of events. Frontier had the ball on the 11-yard line of Drury. And Wordley got stripped as he ran to the outside. Harrison picked up and ran it back 85 yards for a touchdown to make it 22-12. So an interesting turn of events. As the Redhawks have had a couple of tough moments that Drury has taken advantage of. But they still have a 10-point lead.
Stephen Wordley, Aaron Landry are back for the Redhawks.
Landry and Wordley back. For Frontier. Bird to kick it away. Short kick, and it's probably going to help the time to go out of bounds. It's picked up at the 30-yard line.
Matt Hildreth on a return.
Hildreth brings it back up to about the 36.
Devon Woodson on a stop for the
which
Devils.
Is where Frontier will take over.
First and 10 Redhawks.
So Frontier will try
Frontier
to rebound back from
six-yard line.
The ugliness of that last series. They'll start in a pretty good field position at the 36.
So reminder, Frontier football parents selling 50-50 raffle tickets. All proceeds go back to the football program.
.6:36 to go in the half. Freeman under center. Inside give to Gawanter. The big man rolls
Seth
all the way
Gawanter
up. Picks up about 8 yards on that one. Looks like. Let's see where they spot it.
Jack Yeaton on a stop for
about the fifth, about an 8 yard gain.
7, 2nd and 3.
Second, I want to call it second and not second and three. I'll go to it. And inside give again. This time it goes to Gawanter again.
First down.
That's good for a first.
John Wood on the stop for the Blue Devils. First and 10 Frontier from the Frontier 46-yard line,
first and 10. As the Redhawks are going to keep the ball, looks like on the ground. Again, Gawanter. That counter run, the right side, gets to about midfield.
TJ Middleton on the stop for the Devils. With help from.
It's a gain of about four. It'll be second and 6.
5, 2nd and 5.
Inside give to Wordley, and he is in first down territory. It was nearly took off, but brought down. At the last minute, that's good for first down for the Redhawks. Down at about the 40-yard line of Drury. That's a gain of 10 for Wordley. Inside give again, and brought down. Who was a care ball carrier, and it was tough to make out.
Aaron Landry on a carry.
It's Landry that time. That's a gain of about two yards. So they'll bring up second and 8 from the 38. Freeman under center. Nope. Got a procedure penalty, whether this is encroachment, we'll see what it is. Let's see what
procedure
they get.
On the Redhawks.
Nope, it's going to be on the Redhawks.
Second and 13.
Second and 13 from the 43. Drury. Haven't been a lot of penalties in this game. Only 15 yards worth for Drury and now 15 yards worth for Frontier. Been a pretty well-played game for the first night over the high school football season. You can see a lot more mental errors than you're seeing tonight. Freeman is going to roll out and pass. Fires it downfield. Complete! And brought down from behind is Cole Price.
Freeman's pass.
And they're going to say, they say it was a
Cole
fumble?
Price.
Yep. Cole Price caught the pass and fumbled.
Daylon Harrison.
So Price caught the pass from Freeman. It was complete. But then he fumbled it. And Drury recovers the fumble at about, let's see what yard line.
Caught by the Redhawks.
At about the 11-yard line. That pass was good for about, looked like about 30 yards. And he just fumbled it. So Drury will get the ball back, trailing 22-12. And timeout Redhawks to talk it over.
First and 10 Blue Devils from the Drury 12-yard line.
Drury's been a couple of good defensive plays has resulted in a couple of fumbles, one of which resulted in a touchdown, the other of which got them the ball back on their own 12. 4:09 to go in the half. See if the Devils can turn this into some points. Rodriguez back in the shotgun again. The motion goes Bird. And a pitch back to
Harrison. And a carry
Harrison.
By a host of Redhawks.
Swarmed by the front line of Frontier, but he still was able to get some positive yardage.
He got a couple yards.
Second and eight from the 14 of Drury. Clock is in motion, less than 4 minutes to go in the first half. Frontier leading 22-12. Has two receivers. Oh, and the snap goes over his head. It's going to fumble. Actually, still loose. And they brought him down, I think, for. Is it close? No, it's inside the five, so that was just a bad snap. Very close to a safety. But it ends up back a loss of 9. And they end up third and 17.
17
five.
For the Devils.
For Drury. Well, that did not go according to plan, and Drury is now needs to be very, very careful with the football. They're inside their own 5-yard line. That was just a very, very bad snap between the quarterback and the up back, and just airmen. They're going to run 3 receivers to the right side. Rodriguez out of the shotgun again. And he's going to throw. And the pass is complete to Bird.
Rodriguez pass complete to 11, Hayden Bird.
And Bird, I don't know what he got. He might have gotten a yard,
except
maybe.
Set the line for 45 on a stop. The Devils at a 4th and 17. From the Drury 2-yard line.
And that was for no gain.
It's about the 5-yard line.
That didn't do anything, so we got 4th and 17. A dangerous situation here for Drury, as they're going to have to punt from their own end zone.
Daylon Harrison
Worthy is back
to punt for Blue Devils.
At the Drury 30. So this is Landry actually is there. It could be a short field here.
The Redhawks.
And Drury, I think, wants to talk about it.
Time out.
We'll take a quick break. 1:41 to go in the first half. It is still Frontier 22 and Drury 12. This is high school football, Red Hawk football, on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Kevin Murphy, and the crew back here at Frontier Regional School, opening night of high school football's 2016 campaign. Independent matchup between the Frontier Redhawks and the Drury Blue Devils
out of Berkshire's.
And Drury's going to have to punt. 4th and 17, very dangerous situation here. If
Daylon Harrison to punt.
Frontier can penetrate.
Back for the Redhawks.
Pressure this kicker a little bit. Could make things very interesting.
Bad snap.
Low snap. They got the kick away. Landry picks it up at the 30. Runs it left side and is knocked out of bounds.
Landry knocked out of bounds.
Inside the 20. We'll see where they spot it.
57, Alex Griffith. First down, Redhawk.
See what the ball is spotted.
First and 10 from the Blue Devil 18-yard line.
So that was good for about a 12-yard return for Landry. So a golden opportunity for Frontier to extend the lead if they can punch one in here. Inside give to Wordley, bounces to the outside, beats the end. Is he in?
Touchdown,
Wordley. Yeah, that was almost too easy. He had one man to beat on the end, and he just blew right by him. So that was a beautifully run ball by Wordley. Kind of redeems from the fumble. And just like that, it's 28-12. A 16-yard touchdown run for Stephen Wordley. His first score of the season, first score of the game. Frontier will go for a two-point conversion. Well, that fumbled snap was costly. And the run ahead by Gawanter is good. Two-point conversion is good. And with 1:21 to go in the first half, the Frontier Redhawks have extended the lead to 30-12. This is high school football on Frontier Community Access Television. So the Drury Blue Devils made a critical mistake on that bad snap, and Frontier made him pay with 8 points. There's Wordley with a 16-yard touchdown run. Actually, make that an 18-yard touchdown run. And Gawanter followed up with a two-point conversion, and that makes the score 30-12. As Frontier will kick it off, back deep Bird for Drury and Harrison.
Like to kick off.
This is going to be an end-over-end worm burner.
Javon Woodson.
Woodson picks it
doubles.
Up. And actually, that was Beta. It's going to go nowhere. Hildreth did a good job on the containment, and that's where Drury will start.
Drury football, first and 10 for me. Blue Devil. 25-yard line.
So we'll see if Drury can find a way to break one here with 1:14 to go in the half. They trail 30-12. It's looking like Drury was starting to make a bit of a comeback, taking advantage of a couple of Frontier mishaps. But they have yet to figure out a way to contain that Frontier running game, save for that one fumble they generated on Wordley. Frontier running attacks were pretty awesome today. Rodriguez under center, bend in the shotgun, and that's going to be a whistle, and that's going to be, I believe, procedure on Drury.
Procedure on Blue Devils, 5-yard penalty, 1st and 15.
First and 15 from the 20 of Drury. Not going in the direction the Blue Devils want to be going at this point. A lot of Berkshire teams are down tonight for some action against the locals. Lee is at Turner's tonight, and Mahar is taking on Mount Greylock. Rodriguez under center, and the handoff goes to Harrison. Harrison gets back some of that yardage they lost and a little more. And see where they spotted. Yeah, he gained about 7 yards on that one, so that gets back the lost penalty yardage. It'll be second and 8 on the 27 of Drury. With less than a minute to go in the first half. High formation again. And the handoff goes to the deep back. That's Harrison, and he's brought
down. Harrison on the carry.
That might very well be the last play of this half. Might have lost a yard. He did. And that's going
to
do it for the first half.
That's the end of the first half here.
End of the first half. Frontier, the Red Hawks lead Drury by a score of 30-12. We will recap the scoring and bring you second half action coming up. This is Frontier, Unity Access Television's coverage of Frontier Red Hawk football. Chris Collins, Kevin Murphy, and the crew back out here at Frontier Regional School. The Frontier Redhawks lead the Drury Blue Devils by a count of 30-12. Quite an exciting first half of scoring, starting off in the first Frontier series. And Seth Gawantra scored on a 1-yard touchdown run. And Steve Worthley caught a pass from Miles Freeman to make it 8-0. Frontier came back on their next series and scored again as Aaron Landry, the 92-yard touchdown run. And Seth Gawantra capped it off with a 2-point conversion to make it 16-0. And Drury got on the board when their player Hayden Bird was able to pick up a fumble. A 64-yard touchdown pass from Rodriguez to make it 16-6. And then Seth Gawantra came back with a 16-yard touchdown run, and the conversion run failed to make it 22-6 at the end of one quarter. In the second quarter, the Drury Blue Devils scored again as Harrison picked up a fumble from a Stephen Wordley run and ran it back 85 yards for the touchdown. Frontier managed to stop the 2-point conversion run. And then late in the first half, Drury mishandled a snap from center and ended up inside their own 5-yard line. They were forced to boot it away, and Stephen Wordley, one play later, ran it in from 18 yards out, and Seth Gawantra popped in the 2-point conversion run to make it 30-12, which is where we stand now. A couple of interesting stats from the first half. Both teams were penalized only, 20 yards for Drury, 15 yards for Frontier. There were a couple of fumbles for Frontier. That was probably the most bad news Frontier had, was they did fumble a couple times and turn it over in the first half. But the individual rushing is amazing. The tally, the big three of Wordley and Landry and Gawantra. I mean, the big damage has been done by Landry. 5 carries, 158 yards in the first half. Wordley, 9 carries, 69 yards. And Gawantra, 6 carries for 27 yards. Right now, the Frontier running game has been the story in this one. And I think Drury's taking advantage of the mistakes that Frontier has made. They haven't made very many. But this is going to be an interesting second half. And I believe Drury gets the ball to start this second half as Frontier received the ball to begin the game. And I think for Frontier, Don Gordon wants his guys to minimize the mental mistakes, keep pounding the ball on the ground, and get out of here with a W, and they are well on their way to doing that. As the Red Hawks come back onto the field, Drury still in the huddle at the far end zone, and we're going to get ready for a second half action momentarily here on Frontier Community Access Television. Again, this is the first of a number of games we're going to do this season. Kevin's going to take the show on the road. Again, we'll be providing commentary as often as possible. Also, our friends from Bear Country 95.3, Jeff Terrell and Sean Hubert. I believe this is their 26th year, some ridiculous number like that, of doing high school football on the radio. And we are going to parlay that into a television broadcast as often as possible whenever the Frontier Redhawks are in action. The humidity is still thick here at Frontier. It is, of course, the first Friday in September, the first football Friday in September, and these games are typically pretty warm. The big thing to worry about if you're a coach on either side of the ball is the possibility of dehydration and cramping up. A lot of cramp-ups happen in the second halves of early season games, and the weather is as humid as this weather is. This is not necessarily pleasant weather to play football in, but then again, if you've been waiting to play football all summer, these kids do not seem unenthusiastic. In fact, I was out here for the warm-up, and you know, this is 45, 15 minutes before kickoff. The Frontier guys were coming out, and they were like, they were shot out of a cannon. They were, you know, jumping around and very, very excited. Of course, big things expected from this Frontier Redhawk team this season. I think that there is a justifiable expectation that this team could go deep into the playoffs and possibly even contend for a Super Bowl. We will see. Drury back deep to receive as we're getting ready to kick off the second half here in South Deerfield. High end-over-end kick taken by Vega at about the 10-yard line. Running up the right side, looking for a little bit of a lane, and is brought down just outside the 35-yard line, which is where Drury will take over first and 10 to start this half of football. Again, Frontier leads 30-12, so the Blue Devils have some work to do to get themselves back into a position to win this game. And the Frontier defense, which has done pretty well,
first and 10.
Containing Drury. Drury's only scoring has occurred as a result of one really good pass play and one mistake. Beyond that, that's about it offensively. They have yet to get a rhythm going against this very, very strong Frontier defensive core. Rodriguez, again, in the shotgun. A couple of backs in there with him. The handoff goes to Vega. He spins back away. It's up to about the 45-yard line. And he's close to first down yardage, but I don't think he got there.
Gainham. Nine,
so got close to it. Second and one from the 44 of Drury. They've gone to Vega a lot. Early on, it was Harrison that got most of the touches, but Vega's been pretty much the guy ever since. Same set, double wide outs, and two backs. And the shotgun is Rodriguez. Honestly, inside hand goes this time to Harrison.
Harrison,
he gets a block on the outside. He's deep into Frontier territory. First down yardage. So a nice run for Harrison. And he is inside Frontier territory to the 37.
The Frontier 35-yard line.
That's a gain of 19 for Harrison. We did not have much daylight in the first half, and right now, Drury's moving the ball well. Rodriguez, and the shotgun again. And this time he fakes the outside handoff, and that did not work, and Harrison gets mauled. That did not fool anybody on the Frontier side of the ball. A little misdirection and an attempt at a counter that just got sniffed out big time. That's going to be a loss.
About 6 yards. It'll be second and 16 for the Blue Devils.
Yeah, loss of six. From the 43 of Frontier. Trips to the right. Looks like it might be a passing play. Vega is the lone back. Nope, they're going to give it to Vega. And Vega, a hop step, gets back to about let's say the 40-yard line. So he might have got 3 yards.
Freeman on a stop for the Redhawks. Third down.
They have third and 13 from the 40.
Third and 15 for the Blue Devils.
Defense! 8:17 to go in the third quarter. Drury has pounded the ball on the ground. With some semblance of success here in the third quarter. Rodriguez is going to throw. Uncorks the pass. Intercepted by the Frontier Redhawks. Miles Freeman picked off that pass. And that is just what the doctor ordered for Frontier, and Frontier will take over on their own 39. That was just, Miles just played center field on that one. Ball spotted up at 30. Dive up the middle.
That's Gawanter on the carry.
Gawanter. Pickup of about 9 on that one. Second and 1 from the 39-yard line of Frontier. They have the ball back courtesy of the Miles Freeman interception. Fumble in the backfield. As the pitch went to Gawanter, and Drury has recovered, it looks like.
By number 22, TJ Middleton, first down, Blue Devils.
So just like that, they get the ball back and they turn it over. That is the third fumble for the Frontier Redhawks this game.
First and 10, Blue Devils from the Frontier 37-yard line.
So that pitch, that's the first time they tried to pitch the ball in this game, and that time that just flat out didn't work. Don't think Seth saw it coming. 7:17 to go in the third quarter. Rodriguez, inside give to Harrison.
Harrison on a carry.
Knocked down at about the 35-yard line, pickup of about 2.
Cade Gawanter on a stop for Frontier. Gain of 3, second and 7.
Clock in motion inside of 7 minutes to go in the third quarter. Now triple wide out to the near side. Rodriguez in the shotgun again. Vega's with him. Vega gets the handoff, tries to cut through, and gets pulled down. On a nice defensive play by Seth Gawanter, who's absolutely read that beautifully.
Gain of 2, third and 7 for the Blue Devils.
That ball is spotted just inside the 35-yard line. On Frontier. Clock continues to roll. 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. Shotgun again. Rodriguez. He's going to throw. He gets hit as he throws the ball, and it's going to fall short. Intended receiver was Bird, who was about 20 yards farther downfield, and that ball landed as he got hammered as he threw the ball. And that was Freeman again. That's going to bring up 4th and 7 on 34, and I think they're probably going to go for it here, I would think, as they're in 3-down territory. Or they could try to punt it and really hem Frontier in, but. Nope, they're going to go. And why not? They're close enough. Only 7 yards away. Rodriguez gets the snap. Passes over the middle, and the pass is complete to Bird. No, it was not complete. Just enough interference, just enough defense there by Ryan Olmstead. As Bird could not contain it, and the Redhawks take over on downs.
on the Frontier 35-yard line.
That'll bring up first and 10 from the 35. Just inside the 35 of Frontier. And the handoff goes inside. And spinning away
Landry
gets tripped up. Gets out to nearly, just about to the 40-yard line. About a yard short.
Tackle 78, John Wood. Tonight's winning 50-50 raffle ticket. $104.
Gain of four.
633-235. 633-235. Claim your price here in the press box. And as always, the Frontier Football Parents, thank you for your generous support. 633-235.
We'll bring up a second and about six.
Second and five for
28.
Frontier Red Hawks.
38, rather, of Frontier. And rolling out is Freeman. He's going to keep it. Freeman leaps over the defender and lands just about at the first down marker. We'll see if they got it. They're going to say he got it.
Carry good for a Red Hawk first down.
And that's the first time Freeman has carried the ball in this game.
First and 10 Red Hawks from the Frontier 47-yard line.
That's good for nine. With a very acrobatic ending for Miles. Freeman under center again, same formation. Landry gets the counter pitch.
Landry on the carry.
And he's at about midfield with that carry.
Kalen Harrison on a stop for the Devils. Gain of five, second and five. Again, winning ticket, 50-50. 633-235. 633-235.
Ball spotted directly at midfield, second and seven for Frontier. Handoff goes inside again to Landry, and that time he gets swarmed.
Got down from behind.
Might have got back to the original line of scrimmage,
TJ
but
Middleton.
We'll see where they spot it.
No yeah, gain
I'm going to say no gain on that one. Brings up third and seven from midfield. Just inside of 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. Again, if just joining us, Frontier is leading Drury by a count of 30-12. Full house backfield again. Freeman, inside give, blasting through into first down territory is Landry again.
Tripped up by 22, TJ Middleton. Carry good for a Hawk first down, first and 10 Frontier from the Drury 42-yard line.
That was actually worldly on that carry.
Last call on number 633-235. 633-235.
First and 10 from
the
42 of Drury. And whistle, and this is going to be procedure.
Procedure on the Red Hawks.
Yep. Illegal
five
procedure.
Penalty, first and 15.
They'll knock the ball back to about the 47-yard line of Drury. I'm quite frankly surprised we haven't seen more of that. It's been a pretty well-played game for the first week of the season. I've covered some opening night nightmares in my career running for the recorder. This has been a pretty well-played game in terms of the basics, fundamentals. Freeman under center, blitz coming, and flags flying everywhere. Somebody took off early, I think. See who they get. That was worldly on the carry. Offsides defense. So that'll give the Hawks.
Offside on Drury, 5 yards.
5 yards.
Remain first down.
First and five from the 42 of Drury. Yeah, it looked like that guy was coming firing up for the blitz.
A little bit
too feisty. Now, Gowanter up the middle. He's close to first down yardage. He is just a bull.
Anthony
very tough to bring
Sierra
him down.
Stop for the Devils. Gain of seven, second and gain of six, second and four.
Again, that counter handoff from Wordley.
Aaron
got
the
ball from
carry.
Freeman and ends up in the hands of Landry, and he's got first down yardage. A little cross buck is an effective play if you can get the timing right.
Stop for the Devils.
It's going to be dangerous if you can't, but it's been working so far.
Down. From the Devils 24-yard line.
That was good for 10 yards for Landry. Now, Freeman will keep it. Cuts back away. Little stiff arm, stays on his feet. Freeman's brought down. Ball squirts loose.
Oh, God.
And again, a fumble. Fourth fumble of the night by the Redhawks. Four fumbles, four giveaways in this one. Not a good situation for the Frontier Redhawks. Ball's going to be spotted at... at the 15-yard line of Drury, and the Devils will take it over. Five receivers for Rodriguez. The handoff goes to Big inside as they tried to spread things out, but nothing doing.
Gawantra
again was able to haul him down.
No gain.
Doesn't appear to be any gain on the play there. Second and 10 from the 15. Inside of a minute to go in the third quarter. Well, good news is the Frontier running game is solid. Bad news is four turnovers, one of which is accounted for points. Rodriguez. Now has a man in motion. And the handoff goes inside the Vega, cuts back across. Nothing doing.
Absolutely.
He might have got a yard or two there.
Seth Gawantra on a stop.
Those two may need a bigger. They got a lot of time.
Yeah, it's going to be a gain of one. Third and nine from the 16 of Drury. And that's going to do it.
We got the quarter.
In the third quarter. We have played three quarters. Frontier Regional School at the end of three. Frontier Redhawks 30. Drury Blue Devils 12. Fourth quarter action upcoming. This is high school football on Frontier Community Access Television. Final frame upcoming. Fourth quarter action about to begin. Frontier Redhawks lead the Drury Blue Devils by a count of 30-12. Drury has the ball after a recent fumble, the fourth fumble of the game, fourth giveaway. Only one of the four fumbles the Frontier has committed resulted in points by Drury. So the good news is that the turnovers haven't resulted in major points, but this is the kind of thing that concerns a coaching staff, although it is the first game, and like I said, sometimes it takes some time to get your sea legs in the game of football. It's going to be third and nine, Blue Devils at their own 16-yard line. Rodriguez, same setup. He's got three wideouts and he's got Vega in the backfield with him. And he's going to throw on third down. Uncorks the pass and intended for Bird, and Bird got cracked by Freeman. Incomplete.
And
that's going to bring up fourth and nine, and this is going to be a punting situation. But Bird got rolling because Freeman came across the middle and just laid a wicked smack on him. That's the kind of thing Wes Welker and Julian Edelman experienced with the Patriots, or used to experience with the Patriots. Welker, anyway, Edelman's still there. this is going to be a punting situation, although, yeah, it looks like a 20-second timeout by the Blue Devils. It's some youngsters from what looks like the Frontier middle school team here, getting the crowd riled up. Harrison back to punt for
the Red Hawks.
The Devils, and Landry is back at the Drury 45 to receive. Harrison boots it away from Landry. Landry bobbles it and falls on it back in his own end of the field, back at around the 44-yard line. So tough break there.
By Aaron Landry at the
but good field position for Frontier to take over.
The Red Hawks take over first and 10.
And the ball is going to be spotted just inside the 45-yard line. Make it the 44. Again, drone coverage tonight, courtesy of Mr. Murphy. Free under center, and handoff goes inside.
Landry
gets popped, brought down at about the 47-yard line.
DJ Middleton on a stop.
And he gets up gingerly. Uh-oh.
Gain of 2 yards, second and 8.
Might have twisted an ankle. That's not a sight you want to see. Although, again, it could be cramping. Like I said, this when you have warm weather like this, although it looks like he might have twisted it, and Landry is going to come off, and that's not a good sight if you are a Frontier Redhawk fan, as that guy is a big part of this offense. A gain of about 2 seconds and 8. And a gain of 3, second and 7 from the 47. Definitely appears to be Landry's left ankle. And he might have twisted it, possible. We're gonna take a look at it, get some water. So maybe it's
second
not.
And 7 for the Devils.
Inside give
Seth
to Gawanter. And Seth pulls ahead to midfield. It's good for about 3 yards.
It'll bring up second,
a third and 4
and
rather.
For Frontier. And 50. From the 50-yard line.
Inside 10 minutes to go in this one. Frontier leading 30-12, and barring something crazy, they'll get their first win of the season. Inside give to Wordley.
Wordley
has got a first down, but a flag. And it's either a block in the back or a hold, I think. We'll see what they get.
Dylan Harrison on a stop.
Yeah, this is going to be a hold. Yep.
Holding on the Red Hawks, 10-yard penalty. The remaining third down. Third and
19 from the 40.
Third and about 13.
That's a spot foul. Freeman uncorks the pass downfield, incomplete.
Pass intended for Cole Price, incomplete.
Intended for Price.
Fourth and 12 for the
Redhawks. That'll bring
it
fourth down for the Redhawks. At their own 43-yard line. Landry is back up and walking fine. I'm sure he can get back in there. Looks like he's okay. And this is going to be a punting situation for Frontier. Their first punt if they do punt, of the game. They've had pretty good success on third down tonight. No snap. And a good kick.
Worthy
kicks it back. Fumble. Ball is loose. Who's got it? Frontier recovers the fumble. So the Redhawks recover the fumble deep inside Drury territory. And they get a break courtesy of a turnover. Redhawks are in business deep in Drury territory. See where the ball is spotted. It looks like it's at about the 20. Maybe inside the 20. Timeout.
Timeout
on the field. We'll take the break. 9:13 to go in the game. Frontier 30, Drury 12. This is high school football. Frontier Community Access Television. Ball is spotted on the 18-yard line of Drury, which is where Frontier will take it over.
Frontier from the Drury 19-yard line.
Wordley has a touchdown run from the 18 tonight already. Ball's in the 20. We'll call it the 20-yard line then. First and 10 Frontier from the Drury 20. That's going to be a free play because that was going to be on the defense.
Tackled by a host of Blue Devils. Gain of 5, second and 5.
Gets it down to the 15-yard line on the 5-yard run by Gwanter. Seth Gwanter is one of the captains of this team along with Joe Morawski and Miles Freeman and Cade Gwanter.
Gwanter on a carry.
Inside draw to Gwanter again. The big man just plows ahead and we'll see how close he is to the first down. To be a first down. To be first and goal.
Jake Labonte on a stop. Carry good for a first down. First and goal, Redhawks.
First and goal at the 10. Inside draw again.
Gwanter on a carry.
Gwanter gets through. Touchdown.
Touchdown, Redhawks.
Gwanter just plowed through three or four tacklers and just was not going to be denied the end zone. And it's 36-12. That is Gwanter's third touchdown of this game. He has touchdown runs of 1, 16, and 10.
Hawks attempt the two-point
conversion. Two-point conversion upcoming. It was making an even 38 points if they can get it. Inside draw. And
Aaron Landry.
Landry's
no
run does not go in. So we'll come back up the field at the end. 8:15 rather to go in the fourth quarter. It is Frontier 36 and Drury 12. This is Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Seth Gwanter punches in his third touchdown run of the game.
Devon Woodson.
10 yards out. A scoring drive set up by the fumble on the Frontier punt by Drury. And with 8:15 to go in the game, the Redhawks are comfortably in front by a count of 36-12. All the touchdowns for Frontier on the ground. Gawanter Landry, Gawanter Worthley, and Gawanter. Hawks getting ready to kick it off. And a deep kick, taking it about the 10-yard line. Vega now runs it up the right side. Vega still on his feet. Jump step, hopped and dropped down.
Corbin Blight on the
at about the 40-yard line. Good return Bulldogs. By Vega, about 30 yards.
First and 10 from the Drury, 40-yard line.
And that will be the they will start the 40-yard line of Drury. Trying to get back on the board. They've scored on a nice 64-yard pass play from Bird, or two Bird from Rodriguez, and then, of course, the fumble recovery by Harrison for 85 yards in the second quarter. They've yet to record a rushing touchdown in this game. Rodriguez in shotgun again, back split behind him, two wide outs on the near side. Inside handoff goes to Vega again. He's not going anywhere. As he gets wrapped up.
Jamal Beta on the carry.
Number 73, Cade Gawanter. Just was not going to let him go. He was either going to take him down or take his shirt off. One of the two. And Gawanter, very, very solid. And that drops him for a 3-yard loss. Second and 13 from the 37-yard line of Drury.
Loss of two, second and 12.
Clock in motion, just under 7:30 to go in this game. Same set, two near side wideouts, two backs behind Rodriguez. Out of the shotgun, hands off to Harrison. Delayed running play up the left side, tries to turn the corner but gets stopped. It's back to just ahead of the original line of scrimmage. About the 41-yard line or so. Gain of four. That'll bring up third and 9 from the 41 of Drury. As the clock continues to roll. Time is running out for the Blue Devils. They want to maintain some kind of an effort to come back here. And the score is 36-12 in favor of the Red Hawks.
Third and 9 for Drury.
Now, three receivers to the near side. Vega's the lone back behind Rodriguez. And the shotgun again. Vega, the inside draw.
Jamal Beta on the carry.
They've tried that all night, and every time it seems like Frontier has stopped it.
Luke Parsons on the stop.
It's a gain of about maybe 4 yards.
Drury.
And that'll bring up fourth and 5 from the 45-yard line.
45-yard line.
And we'll see if they kick it. They may not. They may just go for it here. Why not? They're down by 24 points. May as well try and get that extra 6 yards or 5 yards. And that's exactly what they're going to do. And they're bringing four receivers. Three on the near side. Bird is the wide side. Rodriguez under center, gets the snap, he's gonna throw. He's looking for Bird down the left sideline, he's got him! And Bird catches the pass, complete, so the gamble paid off.
Complete for a
Bird
Blue Devil first down
into Frontier territory at the Frontier 25-yard line.
First and 10 from the Red Hawks 25-yard line.
30 yards. Again, trips to the right. Rodriguez is going to throw again on first down. Over the middle, pass complete.
Yep,
they're going to say he caught it. Yeah, that was Bird.
Hayden Bird. Completion inside the Frontier.
First and goal.
5-yard line, first and goal, Blue Devils.
As So Bird now. Four catches for 116 yards in this game. Pretty impressive.
Timeout called.
You consider
by
the fact that
Drury.
Rodriguez has kept the ball on the ground most of the game. They haven't thrown it much, and Bird has caught passes back to back here. For 30 and 20 yards in the last two plays. So right now, the Drury Blue Devils are threatening here. First and goal at the Frontier 5, so we may not be done yet. This is the first of a number of broadcasts of high school football you're going to see this year. We'll be out and about, not just here. There's only four Frontier home games, but also on the road this year.
First and goal, Blue Devils.
First and goal for Drury from the Frontier 5. Rodriguez out of the gun. He's going to throw again. Rodriguez lobs it to the end zone. Touchdown. As Harrison.
Pass complete to
and a
number
flag.
Two, Jalen Harrison for a Blue Devil touchdown.
And that's going to be for
play.
A late hit. That was a Harrison that plowed as he caught the ball in the corner of the end zone. So that's a touchdown.
Personal foul on the Red Hawks.
Yeah, no, I know.
So that, I think, penalty will be assessed on the kick. I would think. So just like that, after running pretty much a ground game for most of this game, three consecutive passes worth 55 yards results in a touchdown for the Drury Blue Devils. Could it be that there's been a bit of an exposure here?
Blue Devils will attempt a two-point conversion.
Not a great secondary performance here in the second half by Frontier. And they're going to run trips to the left side this time. Rodriguez gets a low snap. Ball is loose.
Fumble on a snap.
And that's not going to do it.
Conversion no good.
The conversion fails, so we'll come back up the field with less than 5 minutes
Frontier
to go in the
Red
fourth.
Hawks 36.
36 for Frontier, 18. For Drury, this is high school football on Frontier Community Access Television. So if you're looking for a stat, if you're a Drury Blue Devil fan, that you got to be happy about, it's the passing, especially here in the second half. Right now, they've, between Bird and Harrison, they've caught five balls for 121 yards in the air. That's been the bulk of the offense. Much of the running game has been contained by Frontier. But the passing game for Drury appears to be catching fire late here. They're still down by three touchdowns, but something, and of course they assessed the personal foul is being assessed at the kickoff. So they're actually kicking from the 45
Aaron Landry,
of Frontier. So
for the Red Hawks.
They're going to be kicking that possibly deep into Frontier territory. 15 yards was assessed on the personal foul at the end of the last play. Scoring play when Harrison was knocked out of bounds after he caught the touchdown pass. Blue Devils kicking from the Frontier 45. And the ball blows off the tee. I don't know how, because there's not a lot of wind here tonight. It's one of those humid valley nights. Worthy and Landry are back deep. It's going to be an end-over-end kick. They aimed it for the corner of the end zone, and Landry is going to go back and take it for a touchback. So Frontier caught a bit of a break there because what they were trying to do was knock it just inside the five, and they end up knocking it into the end zone, so it's going to be a touchback, and Frontier will start at their own 20. First and 10, Red Hawks, the 20-yard line. Again, 4:49 to go in the fourth quarter. 36-18 is our score. Hawks have led the whole way. They scored on their first series. Very impressive first series that only lasted 6 plays and 1:49. Inside handoff.
Number 30, Corbin Blight on the carry.
And that is Corbin Blight, the freshman, getting some playing time. And he gets 5 yards off the top.
Nick Arnold on a stop for the Blue Devils.
I would expect Don Gordon to just keep the ball on the ground and easily chew up the rest of this clock with an extended drive here. Inside draw to Gawanter.
Seth Gawanter on
the carry. Seth plows ahead, just shy of the first down.
T.J. Middleton on a stop.
Gets the ball up to about the 29-yard line. Maybe the 28. Third and 2 from the 28 of Frontier. Clock is in motion, under 4 minutes to go. Pom-poms are flying as the students get pumped up. Again, inside draw. That should be good enough for a first down. And again, that was Gawanter. Nothing fancy, just blasting up the middle, although he only got 1 yard there, so it's 4th and 1. Thought he had it, but they're going to say he was a yard short. I would think that this would be pretty much just a straight dive again.
As
Worthley just plows his way through. And that's good for a first down.
T.J. Middleton on a stop.
Out past the 35-yard line to about the 36. That was good for 7 yards.
First down, first and 10 Frontier.
3 minutes to go in the game.
From the Frontier 36.
Well, Frontier is going to win this game, but there definitely are some teachable moments here. 4 turnovers in the game. And 121 yards in passing by a Drury team that didn't pass the ball for the first 3 quarters. Worthley again, still on his feet. It's up to about the 44. Pretty shy of the first down by about 2 yards.
Gain of 9, 2nd and 1 for the Redhawks. Yep, he
got 9 on that one, so 2nd and 1. From the 45-yard line. Clock is rolling. 2:15 to go in the game. Good news is that it looks like that injury to Aaron Landry earlier may have just been cramps because he's back out there.
Flags
on the play, and we'll see who they get here. This looks like a legal procedure. It's probably going to be on Frontier.
Procedure on the Redhawks, 5-yard penalty. 2nd and 6.
2nd and 6 is the word for the 39-yard line. Just under 2 minutes to go in this one. Another procedure penalty. This is the kind of thing that's going to drive Don Gordon nuts.
Second.
Now it's going to be 2nd and 11 from the 34. And I think that Don may want to talk about this. Timeout Frontier. 1:43 to go in the game. Frontier 36, Drury 18. We'll take a short break. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Kevin Murphy, and the gang here. Frontier Regional School, opening night of the 2016 high school football campaign. This is an independent game. And Frontier, of course, there's a bit of a new alignment this year in the Intercounty League. There's some new teams that are in.
Second
Franklin Tech is in.
For the Red Hawks.
And Frontier will play them later this year at Tech. That's going to be a great game. And Amherst is also in this league now. So a little of a realignment. And the playoff picture is always what it is. But this Frontier team, a lot of big expectations this year, especially with the powerhouse lineup they have in that backfield. Inside handoff. And that is
Landry.
Plows ahead. It's out past the 40 to about the 43-yard line. And that's going to bring up a second and about four. So Landry got seven on that one.
Third and five.
About a minute to go in the game. Inside handoff to Wordley. Wordley gets pulled down. He's close to first down yardage. May very well have it. We'll see where they spot the ball.
Zach Yeaton on a stop for the Blue Devils.
It's going to be at the 45, so.
Very good for a Red Hawk first down.
Yep, he got it. They're going to spot it at the 46. A bit of a generous spot there. We'll take it. As the clock rolls down, and they may get one more playoff. But Frontier is going to win this one, and they're going to win it handily. And quarterback will take a knee, Miles Freeman.
That's the end of the game here at the Frontier.
That is it.
The final score. The Frontier Red Hawks.
Go to 1-0 on the season. Red Hawks 36, Drury 18.
October 8th. 3 o'clock against
Congratulations
Springfield.
To the Hawks as they take this one in handy fashion. Rushing touchdowns, three of them from Seth Gawanter, one from Aaron Landry, and one from Stephen Wordley as the Red Hawks come away with this one in convincing fashion. The final score from Frontier Regional School, Frontier Red Hawks 36, Drury Blue Devils 36-18. For Kevin Murphy and all the crew, Frontier Community Access Television, I'm Chris Collins. We'll talk to you next time on Frontier Red Hawk Football.